Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. In this video, we will talk about a few videos that are circulating on YouTube community regarding DevOps and how it is going to die in very few months, if not days. So I came across a couple of videos last night. Those were talking about how DevOps is going to die and how the whole role of DevOps engineer has been evolving into different roles. So for the sake of the video, they were mentioning the developer's role or SRE role, site reliability engineer's role, or operations role, and these are getting separated, which honestly I don't agree with, and that's what the whole point of this video. So I'll mention three specific points which make you understand why DevOps engineer if you are a DevOps engineer, you are not going anywhere. You will have the job in coming 5 years, and actually you will grow in this job if you hang on to a few of these skill sets that you will require. So to start with, the first point I would like to mention is segregation of duties. So we have noticed that there are a bunch of roles in software development that require you to do development part, to do front-end development, to do back-end development, to do this CI/CD pipeline, to do the continuous integration and deployment on the cloud, and also the scripting to automate all these processes. So to be honest, as a software developer for with about 4 to 5 years of experience recently working with the cloud, I personally don't think that this kind of role is specific to DevOps, where we just talk about the CI/CD pipeline, where we talk about the growth, how to automate stuff, how to utilize cloud, how to use tools like Jenkins for CI/CD integration, how to get the delivery out with the minimum viable product. All of these things are not going anywhere. I know these are agile methodologies, and some of them might not survive in coming few months, but for the most part, the practice that we have been doing for the 4 or 5 years is gonna stay the same. And the part of that being, if you ask a developer to develop an end-to-end solution, it probably will take him, if he's a front-end developer, it probably will take him say for example 2 sprints of 2 weeks each to develop a front-end solution with whole JavaScript, HTML, CSS and everything. But for the backend, he might take, or for the database layer, he or she might takes a lot of time, and that's where the segregation of duty comes in. So if you want to have a minimum viable product out fast, you would want to have someone who can really takes care of your delivery, not just the product and how it is built, but also the delivery. So this was my first point. The second point is regarding the SRE and how DevOps is different than SRE and how it won't evolve into SRE completely. So site reliability engineering, when we talk about it, is completely based on the ops side of the DevOps culture, right? So if you are just a operation developer, or you're a system admin, or you are someone who is dealing with the servers and the backends and the networks, those things are good to know for SRE. Actually, those things are necessity for such roles. While in case of DevOps, you not only need to know all of this, but you also need to know the continuous integration, what build tool you are using. If you are using, say for example, if you are building a Spring Boot application, what build tool like Maven or Gradle, what tool are you using for the delivery. Then again, automation is a big part of DevOps, but at the same time, for the most part, automation is also present in SRE, and the automation of servers, how configuration management tools like Ansible or Puppet or Chef is integrated with the environment, and how you know you can manage the patching of those servers, or you know you are building up something that is that uses infrastructure as a code, so something like CloudFormation or Terraform or anything, any tool that is cater more towards the operation side of the business. Not saying there's anything wrong, or you know this is something that you know you will not see in future days or years. But the whole point here is to clarify that if you are a DevOps engineer, your role is not going anywhere. But if you have a skill set, and we'll talk about those skill set later in this video as well. So third point, and the last point I would like to mention here, to conquer the proposition that a few YouTubers are making, is that the tools like full CI/CD pipeline, or that is built on top of any particular cloud provider. So say for example we have Azure for DevOps, we have Code Deploy, Code Commit, Code Build, and all these tools for AWS. And those are vendor proprietary tools, right? So we cannot do much about these. And if you're using those, if you're dependent on those tools, you're dependent on one particular, tool or cloud service provider. Whereas in current scenarios, a DevOps engineer must know what CI engine is, you know, how scripting is done in Python, how you do shell scripting, or how you know how you can leverage infrastructure as a code in form of CloudFormation or Terraform to build up the infrastructure, and then the application part itself, like how to get the release, what are what is blue-green deployment, what is immutable deployment, all those concepts will stay in the same point. But you can leverage, like currently I'm pretty sure 70-80% of the companies are utilizing these tools which are not vendor specific. What that means is it's not just Code Deploy or Code Commit or Code Code Deploy, Code Commit, Code Pipeline to have a release on AWS cloud. People are leveraging Jenkins, Bamboo, all these tools integrated with GitHub, with other tools, Bitbucket or any other tool, those are open source tools for the most part, and those are those you can integrate easily with the cloud. So to state the point again, the difference between the vendor specific CI/CD pipeline or vendor specific DevOps versus the open source tools that almost 70-80% companies are using is a big difference, and that 70-80% companies will take at least 10 years down the road to be vendor specific, to go vendor specific, and that too if they realize that these services provided by these cloud companies are good enough to support their infrastructure and their application and their all the releases that they do frequently. So these are the three important parts that I wanted to talk about today in this video. And lastly, we want to talk about the and the tools and the skill set that you need to have as a DevOps engineer, because we don't want you to lose your job, you know. So it's really important to understand what tools are required for DevOps. I created one video regarding the fundamentals of DevOps and you know, what tools you will require or you will need to at least start with the DevOps engineering role or even SRE role. I'll find that video link in the description box below. But also, to say the least, the fundamental tools are one, at least you should know about one of the operating systems. So I would prefer Linux, since those are the servers mainly where the companies build their infrastructure on and deploy their applications on. So operating system Linux, and then we have a programming language, which a scripting language, basically either Python or shell scripting, and the third will be something that you should add in your bucket list, and that is the cloud technology. So what cloud technology you are using, AWS or Azure, at least know one of these, because this is gonna go a long way for you. And lastly, the build or the deployment tool, the CI/CD tool, so GitHub, Jenkins, all those tools, source code management, to continuous integration engine, to, you know, to the deployment and the build tools like Maven and Gradle. At least you should have understanding and good hands-on experience on these two tools to get into this DevOps engineer role. So I think this is my reply to all such videos which, you know, are saying that infrastructure as a code is going away and infrastructure is code is coming. So I mean, it is coming, but at the same time, DevOps engineers are not going anywhere. DevOps engineers are gonna learn all this stuff and they're gonna survive. So that's it. Thank you guys for watching this video. This is Abir Khan signing off. Take care. Bye.